but as you can see, this is the Alice Project. What you're hearing in the background right now is part of the original soundtrack for it, and I need to turn it down because it's quite loud. So, as you can see, this is a wallpaper from the game. I got this image from Steam, where you can get the game on PC, you can get it on Xbox 360, but either way, there's a key down there so you know what images are mine. Now, the synopsis for this game, I'm planning to have an element of controlled madness to this project. See my pun? Either way, the project is just going to be a simple review on the game, and it's inspired by the classic novel by Lewis Carroll, which you may all know as Alice, Alice's Adventures in Wonderland. I'll condense the gaming experience into a very small video review and an audio podcast. Expect to see a blend of formalities with the novel aspect of things and some informalities when I actually speak about the game. Now, first of all, what is Alice Madness Returns? As you can see from here, it is a game developed by Spicy Horse and it was designed by American McGee. It came out in 2011 around July and is for PC, Xbox 360 and PS3. Unfortunately, PC Master Race, it isn't on Steam anymore, so get a physical copy. The game's a single-player platformer with elements of psychological horror, which planted the game an M rating in the US and 15 rating over here. The game focuses on Alice after the events of the first game, American McGee's Alice, which came out in 2000, in the world of Victorian London. There are a few cutscenes that can play, and they're in a very original 2D style. Now, there are other titles a bit like Alice Madness Returns, which I just thought I'd, you know, shine a light on. You have Akaneira Demon Hunters, which I like to call Red Riding Hood in Feudal Japan, and American McGee's Grimm. The reason why I highlighted these two titles is because they're based on stories. So the tagline is, for a bit of a pun, it's see through the looking glass. The project is just going to show people how games like Alice Madness Returns can play an interesting homage to classic novels. Since you can see various interpretations through film, through plays, and there's not a lot of novel interpretation through video games. I want the audience to see this review and have just an interesting adaptation to see. Now, target audience will be two clear demographics, people who enjoy reading and gamers who prefer single player experiences. I believe that these two demographics will easily be blended in due to the fact that this game has those two demographics. And the advantage to this entire project and the subject matter is that the game does not claim to be a full adaptation, it's just inspired by it. What's in the review? Now, it's going to be a blend of video and audio work with the style of a review from gaming website, for example, IGN. The video will be very informing in terms of the art direction, gameplay mechanics, as well as a personal opinion of the game. That's going to be the main substance of the video review. With the podcast, I'm going to follow more on the story aspect of the game and how close it ever got to the original tale. Treatment, this is the very gritty, what is actually going to happen. Project, I'm featuring video reviews of the game, as well as an audio-only podcast. The video review will hopefully be filmed in the TV studio, as well as the podcast being filmed in the radio studio. I'm going to use a video camera to video the review, and video the review while done either, in the TV studio, and I shall use a series of microphones in the radio studio. I'll put this together by setting up a tripod, stabling cameras, etc, etc. And there'll be a medium shot for the visual review so you can see some expressions. Since, if you haven't known, I'm very talkative with my hands. Now, location, there'll be my house because I need to record some gameplay for the review. There'll be the TV studio and the radio studio. Please don't stalk me. There's all the references, and to add something, you've all probably noticed what these symbols are, or if you're noticing what the hell they are. These symbols are the astrological symbols, and I thought I'd mention them at the end because they're throughout the game, and they actually hold meaning to the storyline. I'd recommend doing some research and references.